Have you ever wondered how the devices in your home network get assigned their IP addresses? Before you say anything, no, it doesn't happen magically. What's at play here is a technology called DHCP, and that's exactly what we're going to be diving into today. We're going to be talking about what DHCP is, how it works, and the benefits that it brings to your home network. So what is DHCP? First of all, DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, and I want you to fixate on that first word here for now, dynamic. When we think about our connected devices, they're connecting to different networks all throughout the day, whether it be our home Wi-Fi network, our office's Wi-Fi network, or just a public network at a coffee shop. Now, each time our device does this, each time it connects to a new network, it gets assigned an IP address. Why does this happen? This happens because an IP address is needed for our device if we want to communicate with either the internet or devices in other networks. So our devices themselves are very dynamic. They're connecting to and disconnecting to different networks throughout the day. But where DHCP plays into this is that it supports this behavior. DHCP automatically assigns IP addresses to devices when they connect to a new Wi-Fi network, and it also provides additional network information as well. We'll focus on the IP addresses for right now, but just know that DHCP is the reason why your devices get IP addresses, and it happens automatically and you don't have to do anything. This obviously makes things a lot easier for us, because could you imagine all the headaches you would have if you had to manually assign an IP address to your device each time it connected to a different network? That would be a lot of wasted time throughout the day if you think about all the different networks you connect to. So the next logical question is, where does DHCP come from? Well, in the vast majority of cases, DHCP is handled by your router. When you set up the router in your home network, for example, by default, your router will take on these DHCP responsibilities and will serve as a DHCP server for your home network. Now, there are a few cases in more complex networks where maybe a network switch or even a computer or a laptop would serve as a DHCP server. But for the majority of you with your home networks, DHCP is handled by your router. So how does DHCP work? Well, honestly, I think it's better if we take a look at an example to see exactly how it works. Okay, here's an example of your home network. It currently doesn't have any devices connected to it, so all you have is your router with its IP address at 192.168.0.1. That will be the IP address for the router for most of you in your home networks. But what I want you to take notice of over here is we have something called a DHCP pool. The Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol pool, the best way to think about this is it's basically just a list of available IP addresses that your router can assign to devices when they connect to your home network. This is obviously a simplified example here. You'll have more than 8 available IP addresses to assign to your devices. In many cases, you have a range of maybe 100 or even 200 IP addresses that can be assigned to devices as they connect to your home network. Speaking of devices connecting to your home network, let's simulate a laptop connecting to your router's Wi-Fi network. At this point, it doesn't have an IP address yet, so what it does is it sends a request out to all the devices on the home network asking, "Where's the DHCP server? I need an IP address. Can somebody help me?" Because your router is the DHCP server for your home network, it responds by saying, "I'm the DHCP server," and then it offers an IP address to the device. So in this case, it's offering this 192.168.0.2 IP address to your laptop. At this point, your laptop says, "Sure, I'll take it. I'll take this .2 IP address." And what's important to keep in mind here is that when your router assigns this IP address to your laptop, it's with an associated lease time. It says here, you can have this IP address for 1 hour. As you can see, the IP address comes out of the DHCP pool, so that way it doesn't get assigned to any other devices. And along with this IP address, as I mentioned earlier, is a few other network configuration settings that get sent to your laptop. Some of this information includes the IP address of the default gateway for the home network, which is your router's IP address. On top of that, it provides the subnet mask of the IP address that's been assigned to this laptop. This isn't super important, so we can get past this. And then lastly, the DNS servers that are used by your router are passed to the laptop as well. So that way, anytime the laptop reaches out and tries to find the location of a website, it will use the DNS servers that the router has identified. Okay, so now the laptop has all this network configuration information. It has this IP address, this .2 IP address, for a total time of 1 hour. And what happens is, after 30 minutes, which is half of the lease time, so 30 minutes later, this laptop will then reach out to your router again, and it will say, hey, I still want this IP address. I'm still on the network. Can you renew the lease for me? What your router will say is, of course, I have no issue with this. You already have the IP address assigned to yourself. Let's just renew this lease time and reset it so it's set for another 60 minutes. This process will continue every half hour, or half of whatever the lease time is set to, until this device leaves the home network and it doesn't renew its lease. Speaking of which, let's see what this looks like. So you have your laptop on your home network. Let's say it disconnects from the home network for a period of 2 hours, so greater than the lease time. It had this 192.168.0.2 IP address for a lease time of 1 hour, but now we've exceeded that. So what happens is, as you can see here, this IP address that was assigned to the laptop goes back into the DHCP pool because that lease expired and the laptop didn't renew the lease of that IP address. So now what we have, let's say we have a desktop join our home network. We go through the same song and dance here. Your desktop says, basically, sure, I'll take the 192.168.0.2 IP address that was previously assigned to the laptop, but now it's free again because the lease expired and the laptop didn't renew the lease. So then this IP address gets reassigned to this desktop. Let's say at this time, the laptop rejoins the home network. The .2 IP address is no longer available because it's been assigned to the desktop. So what happens is we go through the same song and dance once again. The laptop looks for the DHCP server and then it asks for an IP address. This time, the laptop responds by saying, do you want the 192.168.0.3 IP address? The laptop says, sure, I'll take it. There'll be a lease for another 60 minutes. And then this laptop will be assigned this .3 IP address. Again, you'll notice, once this .3 IP address gets assigned to the laptop, it comes out of the DHCP pool once again. Okay, you think you have a good hang of it now? So now let's see what happens. We have another device join our home network. Let's say we have this mobile phone connect to our router's Wi-Fi network. This same DHCP request and offering of an IP address from the router to the device happens again, and then this mobile phone gets assigned the .4 IP address, which then comes out of the DHCP pool. Let's say we then set up a server. We connect the server to the network that our router is broadcasting. Same thing happens, it gets offered another IP address, and now it gets the .5 IP address. And so on and so forth. And as devices leave the home network, once their leases expire, the IP addresses go back into this DHCP pool, which will then reassign that IP address to another device once it connects to the home network. And this is the beauty of DHCP. As I mentioned previously, you don't have to worry about your devices getting assigned IP addresses every time they connect to a new network, because whatever the DHCP server of that network is, they will automatically assign your device with that IP address that comes out of the DHCP pool. Another thing I need to mention here is that there are some cases where you don't want to have a dynamic IP address assigned to your devices. These are cases where we need to assign a static IP address. If you're curious in how you go about doing that, I've previously made a video that details all of that. But what this basically means is you're taking one IP address and you're saying, this device will always get this IP address, no matter how long it's disconnected from the home network, how long it's connected to the home network, it always gets that IP address. And this is an important point here, because those static IP addresses, those come from an IP address range that is different from the DHCP pool that your router uses when it's assigning IP addresses dynamically. Of course, you don't want to assign a device with a permanent IP address and then have that DHCP server try to assign that same IP address to to a different device once it joins the home network. So what you'll notice is the DHCP pool range that's assigned is not the list of all the available IP addresses that your router can assign to devices. You'll want to take a small subset of that to dynamically assign to devices when they connect to your home network, but you also want to have IP addresses on the side so you can statically assign them to the devices that need it. I'd love to see in the comments section if you want me to do a breakdown of your router settings, so that way we can evaluate all the DHCP settings within your router. I'd be happy to make that video if there's interest. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.